all. Everything belongs to you. Second verse. But is under tutors and governors until the time appointed of the Father. And you're under training till you mature up to handle what you're praying for or asking for. God really never tells you no. He tells you to get ready for it. Prepare for it. You want to own a business? I can give it to you, but can you handle it? You want a husband? Are you a wife?
Yeah.
Are you going to beat him up for what the last guy did? He didn't do that to you. But yet he's paying for everything that last guy did to you for the rest of his. That ain't fair to him. God said, I can't send you that prince yet. You got to get over that last stuff. That means you got to grow up something. Grow up, I'll send you. Oh, God. Ouch. Ouch. See, the more mature you act in God, the more he'll let you have things. One talent. What is it? Two talents and five responsibilities. He took the five, turned it into 10. What God say? Same thing he said to the one who turned the 2 and 4. Well done, I good and faithful servant. You've been you're faithful over a few things. Maturity now going to make you ruler. So God believes in promotion as you go.
Amen.
So if you do right on this level, you automatically going to get promoted on the next level.
Yeah.
So you treat him or her right, whether you're going to be with him or her. You treat them right regardless how they act. Why? Because whether you're going to be with them or not, God's watching.
Amen.
And God said, don't even worry about it. This is just practice.
Yeah, exactly.
Either they get their act together, or I got something else for you. But you practice the behavior, so either way, you can either that person can inherit that good behavior, or this one can. Now, what's it going to be? That's up to the other person.
Yeah.
I'll give God a hand clap. Yeah. I'm praying, Lord, help me with my children. Someone say, Lord.
Lord.
Help me with my children.
Help me with my children.
Show me what to do.
Show me what to do.
Y'all pray so good. Say, Lord.
Lord.
Forgive me of my sins.
Forgive me of my sins.
Lord.
Lord.
Give me increase on my job.
Give me increase on my job.
Lord.
Lord.
Heal my body.
Heal my body.
Lord, protect me.
Lord, protect me.
From my enemies.
From my enemies.
We're all praying so good. Say, Lord.
Lord.
I'm trying to get you to understand this is how simple it is to pray. And you got to, see, that's going to turn into God responding to you and revealing his voice to you. You're going to say, Lord, help me with my kids. He's going to say, this is what you do. Now, he doesn't speak like you hear me. He speaks through his spirit.
Amen.
You will feel the presence of God come upon you. And you will be thinking a thought. And that will be what you should do about it. Come on now. Come on now. That's why you say my thoughts are not your thoughts. Not my voice is not your voice, my thoughts. I'm going to talk to you straight, directly in your spirit. And your spirit is going to have thoughts. And you're going to get these thoughts in your mind. And if you struggle with, is that the devil? Is that me? Is that God? God said, I'll make sure you know I will anoint you.
Yes.
I will anoint you. My presence will come upon you and say, this way, this way. So when you're praying, you're not just speaking up to the ceiling, but you're getting signals back.
Amen?
Amen? Amen. Yes, yes. So if you're not experiencing that, that means that you need to be more serious about it, and you need to designate a prayer time with God.
Yeah.
He's that important.
Yeah.
Designate every morning at whatever. Me, I'm 5 in the morning. You can do it in the middle of the day. You can do it at night. Doesn't matter. But once you dedicate it, don't let nothing get in the way of it.
Yeah.
Nothing's more important than that. Start off with 10 minutes. 10 minutes. How do I do 10? Ooh, that's a long time. Pastor does 2 hours and 5 hours. Because that's how much stuff I'm getting back from God. But I'm asking you 10 minutes. Here's what you do. In your 10 minutes, read 3 verses.
Yes.
Read 3 verses. Write down what you think they mean to you. Don't have to be right. Just write it down. This is what I got out of what I just read. This said this. After you do that little 10 minutes and you write that down, okay, now say what you want to say to God. Anything. Write down your thoughts that you think afterwards. After you do that, sometimes, now this order could be any order. This could be any order. You're going to find that you can do more than 10 minutes. Put on a gospel song.
Amen.
Give God some praise.
Thank you, Jesus.
All this is part of your prayer. Mm-hmm. Worship Him.
Yes, Lord.
Yeah.
Sing Him a song.
Yeah.
I love you, Jesus.
Yes.
Worship the hand and adore you. There ain't nobody around, so you can.
I love you, Jesus. Yeah.
You can howl, but ain't nobody listening. I love the hand and adore you. Ooh. You know how good you sound when you're by yourself. God love it. God don't care if you sound like Scooby Doo. He don't care. He don't care. He don't care. He cares that your heart is trying to talk to him. Your heart is trying to sing to him. That's what he cares about. You don't know God got power. You don't know if God takes your voice, changes it before it hits his ear. You don't know what he does. You might sound like an angel in your true form, but to you, you sound like your flesh, and you don't like that. But you don't know in God's ear, it sounds like music to your ear. God. And I know it got to be true, because my baby girl can't sing a lick, but when she sing, I just crumble. She be, hey. You doing something. I don't know. We're going to work on that, baby. You know your pastor is music, and you know, we're going to fix that. all of them got to sing. Stand on your feet, everyone. I just want to share some information. Not so much preach today, because